In this vlog, we will see how a butter knife works. So, butter knife is a data binding library by which we can bind our UI components into our Java code. So, in my previous vlogs, I have shown you data bindings using the native approach. So, this is by using a library. So, first we will see the dependencies required for butter knife. So, here we need to add these two dependencies, and for recycler view I'm adding this to show a list. Okay, so first we will make our layout ready. So here you can see there are different views. You can see here, so here it's an edit text, and this is a button to save the user input from edit text, and this is a text view to show the user input, and this is an image. So all these things I will be showing you how to handle with the help of a butter knife library. So here these are two buttons. Why? Because one is for list view and another is for fragment. I want to show the butter knife usage in activities, in list adapters, and also in fragments, so that you can get a clarity of what is the usage and how easier it is than the native binding. I mean native declaration. So here is a checkbox also. We can handle all kinds of UI elements with the help of this data binding library. So let's get on with the code. Here I have used constraint layout for development of the for designing the screen. So if you are having any problem with the constraint layout, do let me know. I will make a vlog on this constraint layout so that you can easily understand it. So in the main activity, let's start adding our code. So the first and foremost important thing is we need to bind the butter knife to this layout. So here I am binding it. If you are missing this line, you will get an error. So be careful while doing this. So here, like this way, we will be binding, like at the rate of bind view. There are different bindings available. You can see bind view, bind drawable, bind dimension, bind color. We will be seeing all this. Okay. So here, the general way of declaring a text view. Here you can see text name. So likewise, we will be binding it. Now with the help of this text name object, we can handle that particular text view. Same for edit text, for image view, for buttons. We will use the bind view only for all these components, for even checkbox. But here you can see we can even bind the colors. So in colors folder, in colors file, you will be having this. So I am using the default color specified by the Android just for the tutorial sake. So you can handle those things here directly, color.assign. So we can declare the variable and we can use it directly. And this is a dimension. Here I have created a dimension file too for text size. So we can use that one. Here you can observe it's bind diamond. Nothing but dimension, and here bind color, and here bind drawable. So I'm using a basic logo, the logo of my site. So I am binding that one and creating an object so that I can use. So here we go. I am initializing. So in this particular vlog, I will be going to show you two types of on-click listeners. So one is the default thing, I think you know this, implements view on click listener. So for which we are setting on click listeners, and here you can see the text view. I am setting text size. So here is the text view I have initialized with bind view, and the text size also I have initialized with bind view from dimension files. So you can see it is very easy to set the text size here. We need not write r dot dimension everything again and again. So just directly we can make use of the object and we can set the text size, and even with the color. whenever you are setting a color in native style, you need to get resources. From there you need to specify the r.color file, and from there you need to it will be a lengthy line actually. So it's a simple now, just like how we set a text in the same style, we can set the text size and text color too. And image dots, image view, I am setting an image, as I have said, right? I am setting one drawable logo here. I am setting this logo to the image.drawable. See how simple it is to set an image icon to. So now I think you are familiar with this onClick listener method, even though I can explain, right? So here we are having two buttons, so and we are having three buttons. So I am here we have specified onClick listeners, for which we are making onClick functionality, like switch cases, general thing. And also I want to show you the special thing from Butterknife. From Butterknife library we are having the direct onClick thing. You can see here terms check is our this one checkbox. So I am directly making the onClick here. You can see the line onClick check. So using this check method, I am making a toast visible whenever we check the checkbox. So here I have not implemented any onClick listener for the checkbox. You can see I have just initialized it so that I can make a toast out of it. So what I want to show you here is we can do like the native style of onClick. Also we can make use of the Butterknife, and we can directly make the onClick separately for everything. It's your wish now. I mean, based on your comfortability, you can make use of either the case. So I have implemented both the cases for you to let know. So yes, here is the view which I have explained previously. Edit text, button, text view. Here text view we have given text size and text color also. So it's the result we have got the text. It's a default text. Image two buttons, this one is a container, you can't see it, we'll see it later, and the checkbox. So let us try to bind the text from edit text and try to set the text to text view. Here you can see, so with the help of Butterknife we have made this set text also. So here you can see the image also. We have set the image view dot set image drawable. So you can see it's very easier way and simpler also. And let us see a list how it will be. So here you can see the list of names. So let us see how did we initialize these things and recycler list activity. So here from layout only we will see. Here I have given a recycler view, so I have taken both match parent so that I don't have any other components in the screen. And in the class file, basically here also you can see I have initialized the Butterknife. This is the most important step whenever you are using Butterknife for bindings, because from here the actual thing starts. If you have not specified this, then you will surely get an error. So here we have initialized recycler view. You need to observe a small thing. Whenever you are initializing the second line, or you can initialize in single line also, yeah, but we need to specify the UI component type also, like recycler view. And here I am initializing adapter and layout manager, and here an array list for populating the names. So here I am giving some predefined data to the names array list and layout manager, and I am setting the layout manager to our recycler view. And later on I am setting our array list also. I am passing our array list to our recycler adapter, and later setting the adapter. So let's get into recycler adapter. What's the thing is happening? We are sending names array list, right? So here we are accepting the names array list, okay, and we are the help of the constructor, we are matching it with our array list, okay, so that we can use it in our adapter. So the data from the names array list is being transferred into our array list, and here we are defining a view holder. We are defining a view, and from the view we are making a view holder, and we are returning the view holder. And you can see in the view holder, this is the most crucial step here, how to initialize a butter knife in adapter thing. So within the generally what we do, we declare here the text view thing, and inside here in place of butter knife we will set it as text view equal to item view dot find view by id r dot id dot text row. So this is the general scenario we need to do, but as we are using butter knife, so with butter knife this is the scenario, this is how we need to initialize. Here we need to make the butter knife declarations, and as the most crucial step I have said every time, so here, but you need to observe this. In activities we are passing only target, but here with the help of target we need to pass the view too. In recycler adapters and in fragments we need to pass the both the conditions here, both the things like target and view. And it's a very crucial thing, if you pass only item view it will accept, but it won't work, you will get a crash. So remember this point, you need to pass both the target and the item view for both recycler adapter and as well as fragment. So for this I have taken a small row file, just only one text view. So next, so here you can see the list of the things with the help of butter knife. So now this is a fragment home. So we have seen now in the basic activity how we can use of butter knife, and in the list recycler adapter also, and now we will see how in fragments we can use this. So you can see here fragment home. So you might see, so how come this is possible? Here I have placed a container. Whenever you see in this blueprint you can see, right, I can show you clearly, yeah, here is our fragment home button and here is our container. So in this container what's happening, let us see. So first we'll see the design. So this is the fragment home, a basic text view, and we'll go into the fragment. Here as I said in recycler adapter we need to initialize the both with the both components, target and view, for butter knife binding. And here you need to initialize the text view, and I am setting the text here. So it's a simple functionality here. So what's the happening is, here in the main activity whenever you click on fragment home we are making a fragment transaction from we are loading the home fragment into container, okay. So this is how it's happening. So this way in fragments also we can make use of butter knife. And if you have any doubts, like whenever we are having include layouts, for example we will be having a header layout, footer layout, we will use it, or we have a same layout we are using in multiple screens, we use an include. So if you are facing any problems with those kinds of layouts, please do let me know, I will make you understand briefly how to use them too in my next coming logs. So one more thing is pending, yeah, you can see here, right, checkbox, this is the main thing. We have used a different onclick listener which is provided by our butter knife. Even in our native coding we are having this direct onclick, but butter knife is using butter knife, how to do this we are seeing now. So here we have generated a toast. So whenever you click this directly you are getting the toast. We have not provided any set on click listener for this. For only three buttons we have provided the on click listener. So this is for this block. And the most important thing is what I found is much easier is like binding color, dimension and images, icons. This is more simpler. And the remaining also the main advantage is the using the butter knife is faster. The usage, the processing of the processing speed will be much faster. In a native, like when you use find view by ID, it takes time to bind the view and set the data, but here it's faster and it's also very simple, smooth. So yeah, if you have any more doubts you can comment in the comment section. And if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe to our channel and click on the notification bell icon to get the updates as I post them. And also the code for this tutorial is available in the description section below. Please visit it. And if you have any doubts, do let me know.